that the queen has walked in herself. Now that the queen has walked in herself. Ja-ja-ja-da-ja. Yes, yes, we are here to celebrate the Wiz, y'all. Say it with me, the Wiz. Yes, my name is Rodney Earl Jackson Jr. I am a San Franciscan, born and raised proud black artist. I am a theater owner of the San Francisco Bay Area Theater Company, SFBACO, and I am so proud to be here to introduce The Wiz coming to San Francisco 2024. Amen, amen. The Wiz, it holds a special place in my heart because, and I think a lot of artists of color who are around my age and older, because without it, we wouldn't be the artists that we are today. We truly wouldn't. And I can't believe that this is the very, very first. Do y'all know this is the first revival of The Wiz ever? You know, these trailblazers like Diana Ross and Ted Russell and Lena Horne from the movie, Stephanie Mills from the musical, these legends are the reason why our black bodies get to express what they can today at SFJAZZ, at the MoMA, at the symphony, at the ballet, at the theater. So I'm gonna get off my high horse, yes, and I'm gonna introduce the incredible producer, because without producers, how do we do this work? And his name is Brian A. Moreland. Let's have Brian A. Moreland come on up. Mr. Brian.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Round of applause for Rodney. Yeah. I mean, really. Thank you. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. How are you?
Good afternoon.
I just got off a plane after being delayed a long, long time, waiting to be here in San Francisco. So I'm going to ask one more time. How are you? Good afternoon. Thank you, San Francisco. Thank you so much, San Francisco. I am so thrilled to be here. Thank you so much for having us. You know, Rodney brought up some of the legends that we've had in The Wiz, you know, from the movie, as he mentioned, Diana Ross, Lena Horne, Mabel King, Michael Jackson. But it all goes back a lot further than the movie. It goes back to 1974 in Baltimore, Maryland, where a very unknown show tried out there called The Wiz. It starred an unknown little girl named Stephanie Mills. And it starred Dee Dee Bridgewater and Andre DeShields. And that same show came to Broadway 1 year later. Critically panned, by the way. Critically panned by the bulk of the press, threatening to shut the show down. It opened at the Majestic Theater, and it went on to win 7 Tony Awards. A historical first in many, many departments. It's the first time a black choreographer won a Tony Award, George Faison. It's the first time that a black director won a Tony Award, Jeffrey Holder. It's the first time that a black designer won a Tony Award for costume design, again, Jeffrey Holder. So many firsts came out of The Wiz, and we're doing it again. This particular production that will open on Broadway, it will open after 45 years. The very first revival in 45 years. It's incredible, right? A round of applause for that. And this particular production has a couple of unknown people in it as well. Our Dorothy is an unknown little girl named Nichelle Lewis, straight from Virginia. She's 24 years old and she has the voice of an angel. We also have Deborah Cox starring in this particular show, all of you are going to have. Deborah Cox plays our Glinda, a role historically played by Lena Horne and the Tony Award-winning and Grammy Award-winning jazz artist, Dee Dee Bridgewater, who originally played the role. We have Deborah Cox. You also get the very, very first and talented and first look at a wonderful man joining our company named Wayne Brady, who will be our Wiz. And for a lot of you R&B fans, we have Avery Wilson playing the Scarecrow, and we have Kyle Ramar Freeman playing the Lion, and Philip Johnson Richardson playing our wonderful Tin Man. There are so many firsts in this production, the list goes on and on, so bear with me, I want to tell you about a few more people. If you are a fan of, let's say, Coachella, or Lemonade, or if you went around the world a couple of years ago going like this for a long time, talking about if you like it, then you should have put a ring on it. Well then, you are a big fan of Beyonce's choreographer named Jaquel Knight, and we have Jaquel Knight actually choreographing The Wiz. If you were a fan of Wakanda, Black Panther, and you went around the world going like this for a long time, then you will also be pleased to know that we have the first African-American woman to win an Oscar for scenic design. Right? The first African-American woman to win an Oscar, her name is Hannah Bleeker, and she is designing the set of The Wiz. We have her here as well. If you saw Ray or Dreamgirls or Django Unchained, then you've seen this woman's work. Her name is Sharon Davis, and she is designing all of the costumes that you will see in The Wiz. It is a first for many, many, many things, and we cannot wait to come to San Francisco. So we are so thrilled to be here. Thank you for opening your hearts, opening your minds, bringing people to The Wiz. The Wiz is a show about family. It's about belonging. It's about friends. It's about finding your place in the world. It's about being someplace where you are welcomed and you are wanted and desired and needed. And who doesn't need that right now? Not to mention it's filled with joy. There's so much joy in The Wiz. It's 2 hours. It is 2 hours of unadulterated fun and joy and laughter. And it's all being directed by the first woman in over 40 years to direct a musical on Broadway. And her name is Shelley Williams. So there's many, many people surrounding this production to make it the best it could possibly be. We have Candy Burris and Todd Tucker, who are also on the producing team along with me. We have MC Light and Common. It's a lot of people. And so I just want to say to all of you, we thank you. Thank you for having us. We cannot wait for you to see the show. And when you come, bring a friend and then go home and come back and bring two more friends. Tell your neighbors, tell your brothers and your sisters and your cousins. I'm telling you, you guys will be our 11th city. We started in Baltimore. We have one more city after you guys, and I am telling you, we have sold out in every city. And there's always a line, and people say, I didn't know. How come you didn't tell me? I'm telling you, get your tickets now for The Wiz. So thank you so much, all of you.
Thank you. You probably don't know this, Mr. Producer, but Miss Shelley Williams was my associate director in Motown the Musical years ago, traveling around the country telling all these incredible black stories. That was where she and I first had our first interaction, and she is the truth. So thank God for The Wiz to have Miss Shelley Williams. Thank you so much, sir. All right, moving right along. All right, we have a special, special guest. Come on in, there are more seats up here, come on in. We have our mayor. Mayor London Breed is gonna come and say some words and give a proclamation. Miss London Breed.
So first of all, Brian, you talked about all these incredible upcoming stars, but you didn't recognize our own upcoming star, Rodney Jackson Jr., who, let me tell you something, he was not only in Motown, but he was also in Ain't Too Proud to Beg. And this guy is an incredible star and inspiration and in the arts. And I am so proud that he was born and raised in San Francisco in the Fillmore community. And I just, to see him grow and to see him thrive is really why we're here today and why The Wiz is so important to San Francisco. And let me tell you, I'm super juiced because, you know, people forget our recent history of what things used to be like, especially for African Americans, when we would watch TV or when we would go to the shows and when there weren't really a lot of shows and things for us to see. And in fact, we didn't have all this social media and all these other digital things that we have now, but we had things like The Wiz. Can you remember when The Wiz came on TV with Michael Jackson and Diana Ross, and it was an all-black cast, and just to see the dancing and see what was familiar to us, that was not normal. That was really breaking barriers. And when you think about it, too, as we think of these people as incredible stars, you hear these household names like a Diana Ross and Lena Horne and all these folks. And can you imagine what Lena Horne had to go through to be in the kinds of movies that she helped to really trailblaze, to create a path? And these incredible stars and producers and costume designers, all of these folks, they paved a way for the next generation of young artists who have no limits, who have an opportunity to grow and thrive in productions all over the world. And when I think about San Francisco as a place to feature The Wiz, I couldn't be more proud. And we've been through a difficult time, and so the need for joy is now more important than it's ever been before. Because there's so much, again, negativity and other things happening, but we can take a moment to experience joy and experience happiness and to appreciate all of what The Wiz represents. And San Francisco is the place to do it. Just recently, the hippest trip was at ACT. And it was sellout, amazing, fun, exciting. And now Broadway SF is bringing The Wiz to San Francisco with an all-star cast and with an opportunity for us to make sure there's a connection to community so that we're out in the neighborhoods, not only providing free tickets in some cases, but opening up the doors to people who may not be able to afford that ticket, but who deserve to have an opportunity to experience this joy just like anyone else who can afford it. That's what today is about, getting the word out, making sure that we provide everyone, not just in San Francisco, but all over the Bay Area. Welcome, Kathy Adams from the Oakland Chamber of Commerce to San Francisco. Everyone experiencing what we have to offer, and the arts bring people together. I see our Director of Cultural Affairs, Ralph Remington, is here today. And so many of our commissioners and folks who are involved in San Francisco, thank you for showing up, because you are going to be the people to get the word out, to make sure that every night is a sold-out show, that everyone has a chance to experience this, and that we remind ourselves of how significant it is to have a production of this nature in San Francisco. And I am excited, because this is like my childhood. This is, you know how we never thought we'd be those people. When I was coming up, we did. I never thought I'd be that person, but I find myself that person. When I was young, you lucky you got this, because we didn't have that. And so that's what The Wiz is. So we want everyone to see, especially young people, because we want to say, see, this is what we're talking about. This is what we want you to experience. This is what we want you to understand, why it's so important that when you achieve success, it's because you stand on someone else's shoulders who went through the trials and tribulations to get us here. And that's why this is so significant. So I want to thank Broadway SF, and I'm excited about the various folks involved in The Wiz, all these star awarded people who are in the industry who are saying, I'm going to focus on Broadway and the significance of that and what that means. And we welcome you with open arms to San Francisco. We welcome you, this excitement, this joy, and know that it is very much appreciated that you chose to be here in San Francisco, that you chose to do this production in San Francisco. So when the opening happens on the 18th, I want all the shows. I want the shows to be so sold out that they're like, sorry to the next city. We're going to have to extend in San Francisco. That's the kind of, that's what I want to see. And as a way to welcome and to say thank you for choosing San Francisco, today we are going to officially, and actually, Brian, why don't you come up on the stage here with my baby, little Rodney right here. Little Rodney been grown for 20 years, and he's still my baby. On behalf of the City and County of San Francisco, we're going to officially declare it the Wiz Day in San Francisco. And on opening night, we're going to light up City Hall in yellow brick red. Wait, are we going to do yellow? Yes. We're going to light up the City Hall in yellow to recognize the yellow brick road. Amen. Of The Wiz, and we're going to continue to make sure that there is a celebration and there's joy and there's excitement. We couldn't be more honored and proud to have you and your cast and the people involved in Wiz walking the streets of San Francisco, eating at the restaurants in San Francisco, and make sure you get your dinner reservations in advance of the show in San Francisco, because we want to show people not just the joy of The Wiz, but the joy of the arts in San Francisco. Thank you all so much for being here today.
Two more things to say to people. So, thank you. Thank you for this. We will treasure this. Thank you so very much. The arts are important. Every single person in this cast is not only a performer, they are an activist, they are an educator, they are a mentor. We have parents in this cast, we have couples in this cast, and all of them believe in community. Every single person in WIZ believes in community, and everyone has a WIZ story. And so, in partnership with all of you here in the city of San Francisco and Broadway San Francisco, the WIZ is honored to give 100 tickets to students across the city so they can come and enjoy the WIZ.
And what are you doing today?
And today, there is more good news. And today, while our cast is on their day off, they are traveling down to San Diego, leaving Tempe, Arizona, we have a very special performance today from a wonderful, wonderful artist named Rima Webb. And she's going to give you guys a sneak peek at some of the music live of The Wiz, offering us two selections today. The beautiful song, Don't Miss the Feeling We Once Had, and also Believe in Yourself. Please give a great big round of applause for Rima Webb. Reunions abound.
I know.
It's a very small community, even though, you know, we're international.
Miss Rima, my love, this is going to be your singing
okay.
mic.
All right, thank you.
Here you are. Is that a good spot? Okay.
Oh, good afternoon, everybody. This is wonderful.
The movie the other night, and when you get older and you live a little something something, and with everything that's going on now, you realize how there are so many metaphors and there were so many things going on in that movie that hit me in a different way. And unfortunately, we're still struggling and moving through those things right now, if you know what I'm saying.
Within your heart, you'll know that no one can change the path you must go. Believe what you feel and know it's right just because the time will come around. You've got to believe in yourself.
Can we give another round of applause for Rima Webb, everyone? Rima Webb.
Yes, Rima.
On behalf of the entire company of The Wiz, I just want to say a great big thank you one more time. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, Mary Breed, for taking the time to come here today to welcome us. Thank you, Broadway San Francisco, for hosting us. And thank you to each and every one of you that has taken the time to come here today. And I know that we've made a pact today that I'm going to see each and every one of your bright, shining faces at The Wiz, right? Yes! And I want to say a great big thank you to you for helping us today, for blessing us today, and giving us your gifts, all of this today. Thank you.
Thank you. Will you help me with this last little piece?
Yes.
We ain't going to ease on down the road for you, but we are going to give away a couple of tickets. We got some trivia. We got some trivia questions. So our first question is, let me see, what is it?
Oh, that's a good one.
Uh-huh.
Well, that's a good one.
Ask it. Mr.
Okay.
Jeffrey
okay.
Holder.
So yes. Jeffrey Holder. Quick. Jeffrey Holder was married to a wonderful woman named Carmen de Lavalade, who was a dancer. And Joffrey specialized in Indian dance. And you might remember him not only as the Jell-O Man or the voice of the Jell-O, if you go back that far, but you also saw him in a movie. It was his very, very first movie. It starred another unknown little girl. Does anyone know the name of that movie?
Oh, my God.
Oh, she got it.
You got it. Yes.
He was Punjab. He was Punjab. Yeah.
You got some free tickets.
You got free tickets to The Wiz.
Amazing. Come on, Miss Tyra, we got you. All right. Number two. This is a really good one because it's kind of a trick question. You want to ask that one?
Okay. That's a really, really good one. Uh-huh. Okay. So, in the movie of The Wizard of Oz, Dorothy is taken. She has to put on her ruby slippers. Now, we have all sorts of things that are twists and turns in The Wiz, and one of them happens to deal with the shoes, the slippers. So, I'm very curious. Does anyone know the color of the slippers that we wear in The Wiz?
Red.
Oh, he yelled it out, Mr. Alex Jones, okay. That was supposed to be a trick question because they're not red. They silver, amazing, okay.
He got two tickets to The Wiz.
You guys are incredible. Thank you so, so, so much. We're only giving that many out. Again, this Thursday, yes.
This Thursday
at the African American Art and Culture Complex. Thank you, Mayor London Breed. I was going to forget my own event that I'm throwing. My God.
Don't forget your event.
We are hosting a wonderful event for the children and for the community of the Fillmore, just maybe 5 or 6 blocks away on Fulton and Webster at the African American Art and Culture Complex at 4 p.m. We're going to have a lot of kids, some other cast members from the cast of The Wiz are going to be there, and they're going to have a wonderful conversation. The choreographer is going to be there, and he might show some of the kids a little dance steps. So if you're available, come on over. We have space for 250 people. If you have a young one in your life, that's who we really want to bring to this, because we know The Wiz, but it's time to give and foster this information to the next generation. So come on out, AACC at 762 Fulton Street. Ease on down the road, baby. 4 p.m. this Thursday. Thank you, Mayor London Breed. All right. I think without further ado, we can conclude. Oh, Miss Tyra, come on up. Miss Tyra.
I live in Bayview. Y'all not going to be mad at me today. So we will be hosting something also at the Bayview Hopper House, so stay tuned for that information to go out more to the middle of the production. Also, there will be more tickets given out at the event at both cultural centers this Thursday as well as the Opera House. So please come out this Thursday for your chance to win more tickets and bone up on your Broadway history, please. And we want to send a special shout out. We have a VIP in the audience, Regina Benjamin, who's Obama's Surgeon General. Thank her for coming out. And that's it. Thank you guys for making this magical. Thank you so much.